Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Nikki J. If you don't know me or if you are just tuning into my channel, that is my name. So for today, we are going to be doing a Get Ready With Me. It's going to have a lot of Kat Von D products, but it's also going to have some of my favorites within the past couple months. So if you are interested in seeing the way that I got this look right here, continue watching. I'll see you in a second. First things first, I'm going to prime my face. I typically never do this, it's really bad, but today I decided I'm going to, and I'm taking the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, and I'm just going to take a look at that, and just put it all over my face. And if you see this right here, I swear to you guys, it's not a hickey. Not like that. I burnt myself when I was straightening my hair last week. Hurt so bad. It's still healing. Alright. So now that we got our primer on our face, we are going to go into foundation, and I just picked this up yesterday. I haven't tried it yet. It's going to be my first time. I'm very excited about it. It is the Kat Von D Locket Foundation, and I picked up the color Medium 53. So I'm assuming you just pop this little bad boy off, and it's a pump. So I'm going to take a damp beauty blender. I'm just gonna put some of this product all over it. Now, I've heard mixed reviews about this foundation. I did hear that it is a great foundation, then others say that it's awful. They've broken out really bad from it. My skin does tend to break out very easily. I do have sensitive skin, so we will see how this goes. Go ahead and start this. And I like to just dab it all over my face first. And then go in and buff it out. And I think this color might be a little too dark for me. And it's a little bit orangey base. Alright, so I'm going to be taking a Sephora angled brush. It's a blush brush, but I'm going to use this to set what I just put down. And I am using the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette. And I'm taking the color Levitation right here. Since it has a peachy undertone to it, I think it'll sit a lot better on my face with this color foundation rather than going straight for the banana powder. I am going to be putting the banana powder underneath my eyes after I conceal. So let's just get this bad boy on here. Just going to set my whole face aside from my T-zone. That's where I'm going to be putting the banana cream. Move on to concealing. I'm going to be using the Rimmel London Perfect Match. Or Match Perfection, I'm sorry, in 240 Fair Light Neutral. And I don't really want too bright of a highlight today since this foundation is so warm. So I'm only gonna go halfway. Alright, beauty blender, and just have their solo album. So now that we're done highlighting, we are going to set that bow. I'm just going to take the same Sephora angled brush that I used before and just dip into the banana powder, which is called Lyric. I've already used quite a bit of this. As if I was baking, but I'm not baking. Lately, I haven't liked the way baking looks on me. Sometimes I feel like a drag. No offense, I love drag makeup. I think it is awesome, beautiful, talent, such artistry, I really do. But personally, not for me. Not for an everyday look. That's not what I'm going for. Alright, so I am going to continue to use the shade and light palette, and I am going to be going into Shadowplay, which is the middle one right here. No harsh lines. I know some people will probably ask why I go so far in. It's typically on female makeup that makes you look very masculine, but to be quite honest with you, for me personally, I like that look. Alright, so I've been hearing a lot lately people talking about spots on their face that don't pick up product. I have one spot, or actually no, two spots on my face that will refuse to pick up product. And it is right here, and then also on my forehead, right here. It's so annoying. I know, there are some of you out there that feel exactly the same way. You know my pain. See? Like, this is so dark right now. Why? So I did pick up the new Anastasia Brow Definer. I picked up the shade Medium Brown, I believe. Yes, I picked up Medium Brown. And I'm very excited to try this. Last night, I did a little sketch on my hand of an eyebrow. And I did like it. It's just, I think it might be a little difficult at first to learn, so let's just see how this goes. Put this up a little bit. Let's spoolie them through first. And I actually did my eyebrows this morning, so it's a perfect time to try this out. So now that we're done with the brows, we're going to move on to the ojos, and I am going to be using Air Patrol by Benefit, primer for the eyes. You really don't need a lot of this. I learned that the first time I used it. So I'm just gonna take my finger and dab it all over my lid. Alright, so one of my favorites that I have been dying for the past 2 months, or I would say about a month and a half since I received it, is the Makeup Geek collaboration with Manny MUA, and this palette is just, it's life. I love it so much. So I am going to be taking the transition colors from this palette. First, I'm going to jump into Beaches and Cream and just run that all across my crease and make it nice and ready for the color that I'm going to be using on top of it. This is our transition. So basically my camera turned off because I had no more memory left on it. I started doing my eyeshadow, and it sucks because I did both eyes, but I'm just going to, I guess, demonstrate how I did this. So I took, I can't believe this just happened. I totally should have just redo it, but whatever. I took an E27 Morphe brush and I dipped into Beaches and Cream, put that into my crease area. So let's just do that. And then I mixed Sora and Frappe and I put them lower than Beaches and Cream. Then I took Aphrodite on a Morphe E36 brush and I did in a V shape on my outer corner and did that out with a Morphe E13 brush. Then I took the same Morphe E36 brush and I put Artemis in my inner corner. A Sephora Pro Smudger brush in number 11 and went in with my favorite color in this palette. This is the reason why I got this palette, Insomnia. I am obsessed with it. I just put a whole bunch of product on this smudge brush and I'm just going to pack it on all over the lid. I'm going to repeat the same process on my bottom lash line. So taking the E36 by Morphe, dipped into Sora and into Frappe and just smoke out that color. Then I am going to be taking Aphrodite on a flat brush and getting it as close to my lash line as I possibly can. I'm dipping back into Insomnia and I'm just going to start that halfway where I stopped at Aphrodite and bring it all the way up to Artemis. I am going to go off camera and do my lashes and my eyeliner, but first things first, I wanted to talk about the lashes that I am putting on. I have been waiting a long time to get these. Every time I tried to get them, they were either out of stock or I just didn't have the money for it, or I was just buying other products and, you know, you gotta balance it out. So I finally ordered my first two lashes from Nubounsom. I got the Bella lashes, and Manny always raves about that. So of course, Everybody knows I'm obsessed with Manny, so I have to get someone that he wears and swears by. So, you know, that's just how we do it. But the main reason why I wanted to order these lashes was because of one of my other favorite YouTuber, which happens to be AlexFaction. If you don't know who he is, you should look him up. AlexFaction. He has Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. He has Snapchat. He's awesome. He's the tits. Faction Lash. These are the bad boys. I am obsessed with them. I already cut them. So these... Or I could just drop them. I swear I drop everything. Alright. So let's try that again. These are the Faction Lash. They are gorgeous. I cut them already, so these aren't the true length that they come in, but they are gorgeous. So, like I said, I'm gonna go off camera and put these bad boys on. Last but not least, we have the Everlasting Liquid Lipstick by Kat Von D. And I've been waiting for this for so long, and I know I say that about everything, but a lot of her products are, out of stock quite often. This is the color Lolita number one. So let's slap this bad boy on. But I love this color. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I love you all so much. Like I said, all my social medias and details for this tutorial will be linked down below. So check it out. Check out my other videos. Let me know what you think about it. Like I said, I really want to be more involved with you guys. So let me know. And I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.